Hi pet lovers, welcome to Gina's Grooming Channel. Today we're going to be doing a full groom on a puppy. This is Sulley. I want to introduce him to you. Sulley is a 7 month old mix. I think his mom said maybe Maltese. We might get some Shih Tzu in there. I was surprised to hear that he doesn't have any terrier in him because of his coat. But anyway, Sulley has a little story and I want to share it with you. Is that when he was a smaller puppy, about 4 months old, he was taken to a grooming salon, a corporate grooming salon, for his first groom. So what happened is the owner let me know that they gave her a call about 15 minutes, 20 minutes into the groom, said he is ungroomable, that he had released his anal glands, which, just so you guys know, is a sign of a lot of fear when a dog releases their anal glands, and they just handed him back to the owner, wet, sopping wet, soapy, unfinished, and with his anal glands expressed. So had a really bad situation the first time, so his mommy found me. We did a little mommy and me session the first time he came. And so this is the first time that he's here for a full grooming without his mommy. Now there's also some things that he has, some matting. He's definitely got some places that we're gonna have to work on because Sulley just got neutered last month. Everything just healed. And at the same time, he also had surgery to remove his rear dew claws. So he's got a lot of things going on. I feel a lot of matting on his ears, on his chin. I'm not sure if I'll be able to get through that, and on his back. So we're gonna go ahead and look into that a little deeper so you guys can see what I'm talking about. Okay, so let's take a look at some of the things that we're working with Sulley. So first off, I wanna mention that I have him on a grooming loop, but as a harness, and this is because he's a puppy. So I have this harness around his chest and under his armpit instead of around his neck and throat, just because I don't know if he's gonna get startled. It's his, you know, first groom without his mommy with me today, so taking extra precautions with him. And then I wanna kinda zoom in and take a look at some of the matting that I'm talking about. This is tight tangles and knots that are all the way to his skin on his head. He's got one really tight one on his chin right here. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to brush through that. I'm gonna take a look at that. Probably we'll need to clipper. And then if you take a look, good boy. He's got matting all on his legs. So I'm gonna go ahead, normally when a dog comes in for grooming, the first step is I put them in the bath. But if they come in with matting like this, and I have kind of some questions, can I get through it or not? I put them on the table and see if I can brush through, and I brush through before I get them wet, before I get them in the bath, because you don't wanna put mats like this in the bath. So let's go ahead and use some of the equipment that we've talked about in other episodes, which for our brushing, we have our slicker brush. We have our conditioning spray, okay. But of course we have our metal combs that we're gonna go check our work with once I get through some of this, hopefully. All right, well, I'm really pleased with the outcome of this pre-brushing. Now, every dog is different, so just to let you know that he's got a wiry coat, so I was able to brush through some things that sometimes some coats you can't brush through without any pain. So he did really, really good. And we got through all of that on his head, which is really amazing. Some of the parts that I had some problems with were I tried to clipper out matting in his armpit. The noise scared him. So I'm gonna go ahead and save that for a time where I have other equipment running, like a dryer or something like that. So I'm gonna try that way. And then I had some issues with his ears. I had to go ahead, I saw some mats inside his ears. I went ahead and cut that out. And then of course, you know, brushing the front legs, dogs are a little touchy about that. So I had to go very carefully giving him breaks for that. And then once I get him wet and we get him dry, I'm sure I'm gonna find a whole bunch of other stuff on him that we're gonna have to deal with, but at least his pre-brushing is done and we can go from there.